What is good, beautiful people? I'm your host, King Lion Blocks. This video will be a little different. It's going to be a review video. I kind of don't want to just do games on my channel. I want to also do reviews since I'm a big anime fan. Also, pardon the bright, wow, that's bright, especially in this light, bright outfit I have on. I just left the gym. Neither here nor there. But I want to say that I'm going to be doing some review videos on animes and stuff. I want to try and do that throughout my channel. And me and my buddy Chris are going to go see the... It's not new, but I haven't seen it yet. Demon Slayer movie. I've already seen the first season of it. I got him to hurry up and watch the first season within the span of 2 weeks so that way I can review it. So whether or not I have him in it with me, I'll let you guys know, but we're going to go see the movie right now. So stay tuned on that. Okay guys, so update. I lost Chris. Don't know where he's at. He's supposed to be somewhere here. So I'm gonna walk up to the front and see where he's at. Hopefully he'll meet me up here. Okay, I found a nigga. Just like the new version of the G.I. Joe 3 movie. They went back and somehow got Dwayne The Rock Johnson to play, I guess, himself. All right, guys, so we just left. We just got done watching the Demon Slayer movie. We're about to get something to eat, and then once I get done eating with him, I'll give you guys my take on the movie. I liked it. I think it was a 9 out of 10 so far. That's all I'm going to tell you so far. Chris, on the other hand, gave it a 7 out of 10. Don't know what's that about, but we'll figure that out. So stay tuned. So we're back, guys. So my take on the Demon Slayer movie. Personally, I gave it a 9 out of 10. My friend Chris, he gave it a 7 out of 10. When I asked him why he said that, he told me it was because he felt like one... we'll get into that later because I don't want to do spoilers so far into it. But my thoughts on the movie, non-spoiler, before I get to the spoiler part, I liked it. I liked how... the characters, it gave you like a little bit of the background of some of the characters in case you hadn't seen the first season, which if you do, if you haven't, you definitely need to see the first season before you go see the movie because it's canon. That's one of the newer things than most anime movies are doing now. They're making the movies canon just like Dragon Ball Z with the Broly movie and the Battle of Gods. Those are now canon. But yeah, I liked how they did the movie for this. The animation, Chef's Kiss, it was amazing. The story, while it didn't feel like you were in there for 2 hours, it was 2 hours, and I enjoyed it. I thought like the characters, Tanjiro's, the resolve this nigga has, Tanjiro, like, okay, so. I'm not gonna spoil it just yet, but just to say, for him to escape out of the mind control that this demon puts him under, he has to do something so crazy, so dangerous, constantly, repeatedly? No, just constant. It's ridiculous. I like their concept of what they say with the, okay, so not really spoilers, but the main villain puts people under sleep. And so inside of your sleep, there's like your dream world fits around you. So it has a certain radius you can go to. Once you get past that radius, it becomes like a wall. Like it looks like you can go further, but you can't. And then outside of that world, out of your dream world, there's your spiritual area. And once you go there, there's your spiritual orb. And if you crush that, you can cripple the body, no matter how strong you are. And like you could just see like all the main characters from Chijiro, Ahsoka, I think I mispronounced his name, the boar hair guy, the lightning dude, and Rengoku, which shout out to Rengoku, man. He deserved the title of Goku in his name because that nigga, like the first scene into it, he just showed what he had. All the fire style techniques, which I'm telling you, the fire style techniques are ridiculous. Like it was just top tier.
Like, it made me want to be a fire. Like, I'm main fire style and everything, even Pokemon, I do fire type. And that just further reinforced being a fire anything in that show. Excuse me. The ending to the movie, I enjoyed it. I feel like it did a trope that a lot of animes do, which I'll get into that also a little bit later. Utilize of each character, I feel like they tried to give enough characters enough spotlight time, but personally I think they just gave like the main crew and the special person the most, which that being Rengoku and Tojiro, the most time. Surprisingly, they did give the brother with the nigga with the boar head some time, which I thought that was interesting, which I guess that kind of made sense because you could do more with him than you could do with lightning hair guy that only has one technique, but it only works when he's asleep, which interesting. I like how they did that, and especially his soul area. It made it interesting to me. I like how they set that up. But I think we can get into some spoiler spots now because I don't want this video to be too long. I don't know if not many people know this, but anything Demon Slayer-esque sometimes get hit with a copyright ban, so I don't want to put a lot of effort into, not a lot of effort, but I don't want to put a lot of stake and time in something that might get copyright claimed. But the spoilers to it, spoilers gonna start here. If you have not seen the movie or haven't even seen Demon Slayer now, I would advise you to make sure you hit the like button, comment, subscribe, the notification, and then go watch Demon Slayer. Then come back. You know, I'll be here waiting. Just go watch it, and I'll be here. Okay, if they're gone now, let's continue on. So the spoilers to Demon Slayer. You guys are on this you're on this train, heading to find the demons and learn more about why Tenjiro can learn fire, kind of fire-esque style with his water breathing technique. On the way there, you fight one of the big bads, the lower tier demons that you saw at the end of the first, in the end of the last episode, and they had taken over the train to kill Tenjiro and the other Demon Slayers, as well as the hostages on the train. It's interesting because the big bad's ability is he puts you under in your perfect world. So Tenjiro's perfect world is to be with his family. Rengoku was, his was interesting. I didn't know how I've talked about that. It was like a hot take. He was in a place where, well, I guess he had two perfect worlds. The first one was they found the monster and they killed it, and they gave you all of Rengoku's techniques. Like, they gave, you could tell that, like, from the ground running frame one, they gave you what this man can do, what he looks like, how much animation. You could tell that they spent a good grip of money on that animation. But you find out that it's a dream, that all this has happened. Then you give you Rengoku's second dream world, where he's talking to his father, telling him that he made he's basically the captains of the fire style or fire breathing technique, and his father doesn't care. So he goes to tell his brother, or his brother comes up to him and tells him, like, hey, this happened to me. And he's like, well, you think dad would love me once this has happened? And he was like, I ain't Dr. Sure. He's the boar hair guy. His was just to, like, go and solve missions as the leader, as he does in the show. The lightning hair guy is Zetsuku. I'm pretty sure I butchered his name. His was just to be with Nezuko, and you know, that's okay. I'm cool with that. But for them to, the main bad had to put them to sleep so that way he can go in and go and kill them as well as take the hostages, which it didn't work out. The plan failed. You got a little interest. They gave you interesting aspects of what each of the main characters' spiritual pressure if you could call it their spiritual area, was where Tanjiro's peaceful, beautiful, kind of looks like that in between the world from Kingdom Hearts 3. Rengoku, scorching hot, his is just, it's like Magmar's backside. That's just like, it's just gray and fire is everywhere. The boar hair guy, it's confusing. There's a lot, it's like basically a cape, and for some odd reason he's able to be in there. And the lightning hair guys, no one can be in there unless you're Netsuku. No one. So if there's anyone in there, for some reason you get attacked by him with shears and he just goes around just cutting you. I'm entirely sure why that is the case. I did get a good chuckle out of that because he was like, you should not be here. If you're not Netsuku, you don't deserve to be in here. And he's going around chasing him. They found out that they have to escape out of this dream world, or at least Tanjiro finds out that he has to escape. He realizes this place is not real. He needs to leave. To do so, he has to give himself a shock, and most they use the dream aspect that if you give yourself a kick, you can jolt yourself out of it. No matter how deep the dream is, that's the best way to get yourself out of it. And the jolt or the kick that this man goes through is he has to commit seppuku or suicide just to wake himself up, and doing so brings him back to the real world, and he goes to fight the big boss, right? They gave this man, like, once he fought the big, once he's fighting the boss, you're thinking, okay, he's gonna use the fire attack, you know, that he used in the last episode. He doesn't do that off the bat. He uses the beginning star move to it, like I think it's a water breathing technique, form 10, and the big boss puts him to sleep. Each time puts him to sleep, and he's like, but each time he puts him to sleep, Tanjiro wakes right back up, and he's like, how is this possible? There's no way he should be able to wake up out of this easily. And he puts it together. He's like, he's actually getting put to sleep. So Tanjiro is actually getting put in the dream world, and each time he gets put in the dream world, he kills himself just to wake back up. And this shows you snaps of it each time. This man, every time he loses, he's like, go to sleep. He goes, wakes up, slices himself, go to sleep, slices himself, go to sleep, slices himself. In a span of at least a good 4 to 5 seconds on this train, this man is killing himself mentally just to wake back up to kill this demon. And the demon is like, I don't know what I'm supposed to do. I keep putting him to sleep. He keeps killing himself. What am I supposed to do? Eventually, Tanjiro wins and he cuts the demon's head off. But that's only the first 30 minutes of the movie. We come to find out that the boss is the train. And so through whatever powers the demon blood gave him, he's taken over the train, and now he has over 200 hostages. Tanjiro and the rest of the guys have to figure out a way to save all the hostages on this train, as well as to decapitate this demon. They figure out how to do this, right? With all them working together, Rengoku comes in. It's like, don't worry about this. I'll take out the first five trains. Nezuko and the yellow haired nigga will take out the last ones. Which, spoilers, again, they use the ability that the thunder or lightning breathing style guy's trope is that he's a weakling coward unless he's asleep. Once he's asleep, then he uses his first form technique. That's the only technique he's learned, but he's able to use that perfectly. So what they used was him being asleep to be able to be a badass in the movie. I like that because there was no way he was going to be able to do anything otherwise if he was not asleep. So Tanjiro and the boar head went to look for the head of the demon so that we can cut it. They found it and took it out. At that point, we're like in about an hour and 30 minutes of the movie. The demon's been killed. They've escaped the train. Everything's crashed. Tanjiro got a stab wound from the conductor, a random side character, because he wanted to go to sleep, because these people on the people that the demon was working for promised him their perfect world if they just cooperated, some shit like that. And so the conductor stabbed Tanjiro, and Tanjiro was like, please no, don't die, because I can't die, because if I die, then you become a murderer. And like, his whole thing is he doesn't want people to become evil versions of themselves, or like to be terrible. He doesn't want them to suffer for things that he understood they had no choice in doing, or he's just an all-time nice guy. Which I like that trope, that these new animes nowadays, they're giving the nice guys, you're no longer the moody edgelords like the Yusuke Urameshi or the Inuyasha or the who else is an edgelord character? Shadow the Hedgehog, but that's not really an anime. But like those type of characters, they're now more goofy, they're more not afraid to cry, like the Dekus, the Tanjiros, the shout out to the old Trigons, Bash the Stampede. Those characters are now coming into life. And so you could tell that they wanted to give Tanjiro, make him more appealing and more caring, because this man had like at least 4 to 5 cry scenes, and each one lasted about a good 2 to 3 minutes. Like, they wanted you to tap on your heartstring, which, being told to watch this movie, when I wanted to watch this movie, I was told that you're gonna cry. No doubt about it, you're gonna cry, you're gonna be rich. And I was like, all my friends, even my hood friends, was like, man, the hood friends that watch anime now, they was like, man, I'm telling you, you're going to cry. I cried watching that movie. I was like, how you cry watching this movie? And so I'm like, okay, I'm prepared, I ain't gonna cry. This man, Tanjiro, had to leave his family. Leave his family in this dream world just to go back to the real world. Like, there was a point where they had the littlest child or his sibling running to him, because they don't know that this is a dream, or at least they're to them it's real. And so they're crying, and it's like tugging their heartstrings, because like, you know that this is not real. You know that this is all a dream, but they make it so real. And the fact that this man he gets put to sleep each time, and he has to kill himself just to come back. He's killing himself from a perfect world just to come back to this world. And you can tell that he doesn't like doing this. Like, the emotion of it hurts him each time. When he gets mortally wounded and the conductor is flown somewhere else and he's dying, and Tanjiro is like, I can't die, because if I die, this man becomes a murderer, and I don't want that. You can see that in his face and his emotion. You can just show that, like, they want you to feel everything from the music. Oh my god, the music, it hit every emotional G spot. I'm telling you, that it just hit. But we're at, like I said, we're at an hour and 30 minutes into this movie. I'm like, okay, I'm satisfied. We didn't kill the boss. Everyone's still alive. Tanjiro learned that demon, that his breathing technique, total concentration, can stop bleeding. Side note, the fact that your total concentration, your breathing, can stop bleeding internally when you find the blood vessel. I thought that was a little cap, but they kind of retconned it further into the movie. They made it seem like if you know you're breathing well, you can control anything. Like my man Chris, he heard that part, he was like, what? He was like, Rengoku was telling Tanjiro, because he got stabbed, he was like, I see you mastered total concentration. Good job. Now, breathe harder. Like, Tanjiro's like, Rengoku's like, breathe harder. Focus, stronger. He's like, find the blood vessel. I found it. Snap it. And he snapped it, and he was able to stop his bleeding. And so he's like, oh my god. Chris was like, what? And he was like, apparently total concentration can fix anything, he says. So, again, hour and 30 minutes in, we're like, okay, This movie is done. I don't know how they're going to finish it with the next 30 minutes, but it's done. Now, we're into the, I won't say it's a bad part, but a hot take, the more, and it's a hot take for me. The part that I didn't like about the movie is we had a stellar fight. People had enough screen time. People got to see some things. Tanjiro went through a whole arc, at least knowing that, you know, this man had to give up what he wanted. We learned more about Rengoku's character. Now they bring in another character, another boss, which at the beginning of the movie, I was like, okay, they really didn't give Rengoku that much screen time. Maybe they're going to do something for him at the end. They did this, and I'm telling you, they gave this man 30 minutes of just fighting this upper class demon, and the fight with that demon was immaculate, except for the fact that, and spoilers, Rengoku dies. Unnecessary death, at least to me. As I mentioned before, my Naruto video is in my Naruto Ultimate Storm 4 when Neji dies. I think that's unnecessary. I don't see a point as to why his character had to die. I don't even see the point where they had to fight this upper class demon, besides the fact it's just to find out how strong an upper class demon is. They give you Rengoku's final attack, which you could tell that they blew the last of their wad on that attack. That attack alone costed them at least a good 100,000. Like, they just threw it all into that attack, literally and figuratively, just for it to be futile. Futile. Like, I have never seen, and I'm pretty sure if I know anything else, I'll have it edited up somewhere else, another scene that final attack was more wasted. Vegeta's final flash. That attack was the combination of Rengoku's attack. He put everything into that just to get killed. And so once he got killed, this man doubles down and he becomes a member of the Donut Crew, which, if anyone knows what Donut Crew is, congratulations. If not, he's part of the group that's most of JoJo's characters are. Who else is part of the Donut Crew? It's mostly JoJo's characters that are part of the Donut Crew. But Google what that is, JoJo's characters, Donut Crew, you should be able to figure out what that is. He becomes a member of them, and so the demon is trying to escape from him. But Rengoku is using the last of his willpower to cut him. And as he's cutting him, he realizes the sun is coming up. And at that point, it's a time battle, because he's no longer has to fight. He's fighting to win. He's fighting to escape, because if he gets burned, then he's dead. Tanjiro and Four Hair Guy realize that this is their time to stab him and to help Rengoku before he dies. And just in the midst of them coming down to kill the demon rips his arms off and he runs off into the shadows. Again, that fight meant absolutely, it didn't even need to happen. Like, they could have ended the fight with the train scene, saved that fight for later, and gave us more time to learn who Rengoku is. I didn't enjoy that how they did it, but I understood that with the anime like this, they needed to add another layer of, I guess, another depth to give the characters more development. But Tanjiro already lost his family. He had to leave his family again. He had to kill himself multiple times. I don't think he needed any more character development like Rengoku dying, especially with the fact that he went to see Rengoku to learn more about his fire breathing technique that he found out. While Rengoku couldn't tell him, he, in his last of his dying breath, told him that if you go see my father, you might be able to learn more. Why couldn't he just do that? Why couldn't he tell him that? I didn't know about that. Didn't know how I feel about that. Didn't know how I feel about that at all. But Rengoku's speech to them at the end, I was holding it up. There was not a wet eye up until that part. And then that chorus hit in, and it just the waterworks started. It was raining indoors. Like, I don't know what it was. Like, the speech had hit me, and I wasn't ready for it. I wasn't at all. Then that man dies, and the characters just realize that they have to get stronger. Otherwise, there's no way that they can be able to continue on the journey that they're going on to free Nezuko of her curse, as well as to rid the world of demons, they don't get stronger. If one of their strongest members was not able to beat a upper class demon, there's no way that they can beat the Michael Jackson demon, which I know he doesn't like Michael Jackson anymore, but that's what I'm going with. But all in all, I give the movie an 8 out of 10. Personally, I enjoyed it. 9 out of 10. I enjoyed it. The animation looked amazing. The story of it was amazing. I would think for it to be a 10 was if they just had cut that part out. Let that be part of the season 2 that's coming out. Let us know some more about Rengoku before you just killed him off. But again, that's just a hot take from me. If you guys haven't seen the movie, please, I advise you to go see it. Either. I always say to support the artists of it and the creators. But if you don't, or if you're not able to do that, and you know you can find other ways to watch it, please do that. Yeah, as long as you will watch it, as well as go read the manga, because the manga is amazing as well. But yeah, if you guys have seen it, please let me know what you guys think about the movie or Demon Slayer in general. With all that being said, thank you guys very much for stopping by on my TED Talk about Demon Slayer. I'm going to do some more reviews on other anime-esque things and hopefully some comic book things because I collect both. And I hope that you guys enjoy that on the channel. So with that being said, catch you guys again later. Peace.